Dear students, in the previous episode, that is episode 25, we discussed the main points or theory part of the chapter 7, that is coordinate geometry. Then, in coordinate geometry, what do you mean by coordinate geometry? Let us consider in the plane xy axis, on the base of the xy axis, the any point has two values. First is the x coordinate and second is the y coordinate. Therefore, the geometry deals with any point with respect to xy axis be known as coordinate geometry. In the 9th class, we discuss all the main points of that coordinate geometry. That means horizontal line is x-axis, vertical line is y axis, point of intersection is origin, then that lines or axis divide that plane as four quadrants in the anti-clockwise direction. Then any point has two values, first is the x coordinate or abscissa, second is the y coordinate or ordinate. Then that point is in the first quadrant, the coordinates are positive. In second, x is negative and y is positive. In third quadrant, both are negatives. And in fourth quadrant, x positive, y negative. That is in the anti-clockwise direction. Then any point P, x, y, be a point. Therefore, distance of that point from x-axis is the absolute value or modulus of y-coordinate. If y-coordinate is minus 3, the distance is 3. And its distance from y-axis is the modulus of x-coordinate. Distance from origin is root of x square plus y square. Then, any point on x axis whose y coordinate is 0, similarly, any point on y axis whose x coordinate is 0, therefore, the point of intersection is origin, it is O 0 0. Then, let us consider two points. That points on a vertical line, the x coordinates are equal. That points on a horizontal line, y coordinates are equal. That means on y axis, all x coordinates are 0. Therefore, it is x sum of 0 is the equation, that is y axis. Similarly, all the points on x axis whose y coordinates are 0, therefore y is 0 be the equation of that in x axis. Then x1, y1 and x2, y2 are two points on a vertical line. What is the condition? X1 is equal to x2 and distance between the points is modulus of y1 minus y2. If x1, y1 and x2, y2 are two points on a horizontal line, then y1 is equal to y2 and distance is modulus of x1 minus x2. If x1 is not equal to x2 and y1 is not equal to y2, these two points are on an inclined line or gradient line or sloped line. Then the distance between these two points on the inclined line is known as distance formula. That means A within bracket x1 y1 and B within bracket x2 y2 are two points on an inclined line. Then distance between the points is distance formula. What is it? It is root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. That is also changed as root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus not to y2 minus y1 minus y2 the whole square, because a minus b the whole square is same as b minus a the whole square. That is the distance formula. Then next one is Session formula. That means any point divide the line joining two points in the ratio m is to n, we can find out the point or the coordinates of that point. That method is known as Session formula. That means P within bracket xy be a point which divide the line joining two points A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 in the ratio m is to n. Then the internal point means that point lying between A and B, or that point A point on the line segment AB. external point means that air we produced it to be, we get the external point. Therefore, the internal point is, S coordinate is what? Mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n. Similarly, y coordinate is my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Therefore, the internal point P is within bracket mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n and comma y my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. That is the internal point. The external point means that plus is replaced by minus, because AP in the forward direction, PB in the backward direction. Therefore, we consider N as negative. Therefore, the external point is P, MX2 minus NX1 by M minus N and comma Y, MY2 minus NY1 by M minus N. That is a standard point. That is not in your textbook, but we know the result. Then the point is a midpoint of line joining AB, that divides AB in the ratio, equal length, that is only is 1. Therefore, M is equal to, N is equal to 1. Therefore, M plus N is replaced by 2, M and N are replaced by 1 and 1. Therefore, that point is a midpoint. Therefore, PXY be the midpoint of the line joining AX1 by 1 and BX2 by 2. Then P is x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. That is the midpoint. That is the application for the session formula. Then let us consider a triangle ABC whose vertices are given. That is AX1 by 1, BX2 by 2 and CX3 by 3 are the vertices of a triangle. Then we know that the line joining any vertex at the midpoint of its opposite side is known as median. There are three vertices and three medians. The point of intersection of medians is known as centroid. Similarly, any line from any vertex to the opposite side is perpendicular to the side, that is known as altitude. Then there are three altitudes, and the point of intersection of these three altitudes is ortho center. We can find out the center in the higher classes. Ortho center. For the equilateral triangle and isosceles triangle, median and altitude are same length. Therefore, ortho center and the centroid are same point. Then, AX1 by 1, BX2 by 2, CX3 by 3 are the vertices of a triangle ABC. Then, the centroid is O, X1 plus X2 plus X3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3, that is the centroid. Then we know that the basic formula to find out the area of a triangle is half basic altitude. When the vertices of a triangle are given, we can find out the area using a formula, that is on your textbook. But in your syllabus, the area triangles with the vertices be eliminating. Therefore, these are the main points of this chapter. That means, first of all, two points on a vertical line, x1 is equal to x2, distance is modulus of y1 minus y2. Two points are on a horizontal line, y1 is equal to y2, and distance is modulus of x1 minus x2. Px will be any point means distance from x axis is the modulus of y coordinate. From y axis is the modulus of x coordinate, and from origin is root of x square plus y square. That is the first main point. Second point, given points AX1 by 1 and BX2 by 2 are not on a vertical or horizontal line, therefore that line is known as inclined line. Distance between the point is distance formula, that is distance AB is equal to root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. And it is also AB is the root of x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. And the session formula PXY divide the line joining any point, joining the points AX1 y1 and BX2 y2 in the ratio M is to N. Then the internal point is P MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N comma m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n. The point is external, that the n ratio is taken as minus. Therefore, external point is p, mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, comma m by 2 minus n by 1 by m minus n. Given point is the midpoint, m is equal to 1 is to 1. Therefore, the midpoint p xy is x, p x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. The line joining any vertex at the midpoint of its opposite to the side of the triangle is known as median. There are three medians. At the point of intersection of medians is the centroid. Any perpendicular to the side is known as altitude. Point of intersection of altitudes be known as orthocenter. For isosceles and equilateral triangles, orthocenter and centroid are same point. Ax1, y1, bx2, y2, cx3, y3 are the vertices of a triangle. Then the centroid is O within bracket x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. These are the main key points of this chapter. Then the next in this episode, let us consider the exercise. First exercise is 7.1. In the exercise 7.1, the first question is find the distance between pair of points. That there are three questions given, 1, 2 and 3. We can find out the distance. What is the distance? The answer is AB is equal to AB. That is distance for beta. Root of, what is it? X2 minus X1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. This is the distance for beta. In the first case, A, x1, y1 is 2, 3. Therefore, x1 is 2, y1 is 3. x2 is 4, y2 is 1. For the second case, x1 is minus 5, y1 is 7. x2 is minus 1, y2 is 3. For the third problem, x1 is A, y1 is B. x2 is minus A, y2 is minus B. Therefore, for answer first one, distance is equal to root of x2, that is 4, minus x1, 2, the whole square plus y2, 1, minus y1, 3, the whole square is equal to root of 4 minus 2, 2, 2 square plus 1 minus 3, minus 2, 9 minus 2, the whole square, not to minus 2 square. Is equal to root of 2 square 4, 4 plus 4, is equal to root 8. It is also like as root 4 into 2, is equal to root 4 is 2, 2 root 2. Units, because it is distance. That is the answer. Clear? Then for second question, distance is equal to root of. Therefore, x2 minus 1, minus x1 minus 5, the whole square, plus y2 3, minus y1 7, the whole square. This is the basic mathematics, that is, minus 1 minus minus 5 is minus 1 plus 5. Minus 2 n is plus. Minus 1 plus 5 difference 4, that is positive. Therefore, 4 square. Plus 3 minus 7, minus 4. Minus 4 square. Is equal to root of 4 square 16 plus 16. Is equal to root of 2 into 16, that is 32. Is equal to root of 16 is 4. 4 root of 2. Units. That is the answer of the second question. Only using the quadratic addition formula. Now, third question 3, b is equal to root of x2, that is minus 8, minus x1, that is 8, the whole square, plus minus b, minus b, the whole square. So, root of minus a is minus 2b. minus 1 is positive, therefore the answer is root of 4a square plus 4b square, that is equal to root of 4 into a square plus b square, that is equal to 2 root of a square plus b square. Root of a square plus b square is not a plus b, it is root of a square plus b square. Units. These are the answer of that question. That means all for each points, consider first point as x1, y1, second point as x2. First point as x1, y1 and second point as x2, y2. Next question, question number 2 for power, question number 3. Determine the important question. If the points 1, 5, then 2, 3, then -2, -11 are collinear. That means given points are collinear or not. Test whether the points are collinear or not. How many points are given? 3 points are given. Collinear means, you see, there are 3 points A, B, C. Move A to down, B to down, C to down, the common point. Therefore, they are collinear points. That means, 2 or more points coincide with one another, they are collinear. Otherwise, that A moving to B, this point is A. Therefore, B, A, C lie on a line, they are collinear. That means, 3 points are collinear means, we can prove that the points lie on a line or the 3 points be same. That means lie on a line, we know that the 3 points be lie on a line, which implies that they are collinear. Therefore, answer for that one is, first of all we consider 3 points, A. Answer, when I got the question for you, that is A, 1, 5, B, what is it? 2, 3, C, -2, -11, then distance is what? That is the basic formula, root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square, that is the basic formula to find out the distance between 2 points. In the case of AB, let us consider A as x1, y1, B as x2, y2. In the case of BC, B x1, y1, C x2, y2. In the case of AC, A x1, y1 and C x2, y2. Therefore, first of all, we can find out the AB. That is x2, 2, minus x1, 1, the whole square plus y2, 3, minus y1, 5. Root of 2 minus 1, 1 square. 3 minus 5, minus 2, that is minus 2 the whole square. Root of 1 plus 4, this is equal to root of 5. That is AB. Then we can find out BC. Therefore, it is x1, y1, x2, y2. That is, x2, minus 2, minus x1, minus 2, the whole square, plus y2, minus 11, minus y1, that is 3, the whole square. This is the root of. -2, -2 is -4. -11, -3 is -40. 4 square is 60. 40 square is 196 is equal to root of 6 plus 6, 12, remember. 9 plus 1, 10 plus 1, 11. 11, 2. 2 and 9, 12. Then 2 and 12 is divided by 2, 1, 0, 6. Divided by 2, 53. That is equal to root of 4 into 53. It's equal to 2 root of 53. Then consider AC. It's equal to root of minus 2 minus 1. The whole square plus minus 11 minus 5. Root of minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3 square. Plus minus 16 square. Root of 9 plus 256. Root of 265. Then 265 is divided by 5. 5 are multiplied by 55. That's the root. That is root of 256. That is 5 only 5. Okay. This are AB is root to 5. BC is 2 root to 53. That this one is root 265. The sum of any two is not equal to the third one. That means AB plus BC is not equal to AB plus BC is not equal to AC. Therefore, given points are not equal. AB plus BC not equal to AC. Or AB plus AC. AB plus AC not equal to BC. Because this is the highest value, this is the least value, this is the second value. Or least sum of this BC2 is not equal to 3. That is BC. No? AB plus BC is AC, that is correct. AC is the highest value. AB plus BC not equal to AC. Therefore, what's the answer? Given points are not collinear. Therefore, given points are not collinear. That is the final answer of that question. If the sum of any two is the third, we yet know that the points are on line on a line, therefore they are collinear. Then question number 4, question number 2, power. Check 5 minus 2, 6 to 4, 7 minus 2. How do you work this as? Of and isosceles, ISOSCELES, triangle. That is the question. That means that the triangle, these three points are the vertices. Any two sides are equal, it is isosceles. Any three sides are equal, it is equal. Clear? Then the next question, that is question number 5. Question number 5 for your homework. Then question number 6. Name the type of hot water. Question number 5, question number 2, homework. Question number 6. Name type of quadrilateral. How many diagonals? Two diagonals. and the diagonals are not equal, that is a parallelogram. If opposite sides are equal and the diagonals are equal, that is known as a rectangle. If all sides are equal and the diagonals are equal, it is a square. If all sides are equal and the diagonals are not equal, it is a rhombus. If two sides opposites are parallel and other two sides are not parallel, it is known as a trapezium. That means trapezium means it is a quadrilateral. Therefore, to test given points are the vertices of a quadrilateral, it is square or any one, we can find out all the four sides and also the diagonals. That means we can find out the six distance. That is four sides, four distance, and two diagonals. Therefore, how many distance? Six distance. Using these six distance, we verify that the given quadrilateral is any type or not. Therefore, the answer of that first question is answer. We can say therefore, we are of one form that is quadrilateral. That is A, B, C, D, and the diagonals. AC and BD are the diagonals. Therefore, the point's answer is A, minus 1, minus 2, B, 1, 0, C, minus 1, 2, and D, minus 3, 0. First of all, we can find out the distance formula. That is distance. Therefore, the basic formula is root of x2 minus x1 plus square plus y2 minus y1 plus square. Therefore, AB is the root of, that is 1 minus minus 1. 0 minus minus 2. Root of 1 minus minus 1 is 1 plus 1, 2 square plus 2 square. So, root of 4 plus 4. Say so, by the root 8. Is it 2 root 2? Or it is root 8. 2 root 2 plus 4 plus 4 is 2 into 4. Root 4 is 2. Then BC is equal to BX1 by 1 CX2. Root of minus 1 minus 1 plus 2 minus 0 on the whole square. Say so, the root of 4 plus 4, that is minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 square is 4. 2 minus 0 is 2 square is 4. That is equal to root 8 is equal to root 2. Then CD is equal to root of, that is CD, minus 3 minus minus 1. 0 minus 2 the whole square. Root of minus 3 plus 2, that is minus 2. The whole square plus minus 2, the whole square is equal to root 8, that is equal to root 2. Then AD, that is the fourth side, square root of AD, minus 3 minus 1 minus, minus 3 minus minus 1. The whole square plus 0 minus minus 2. So, that is minus 1 plus 1, minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2. So, that is root 8, this is equal to root 2. That means all sides are equal. Therefore, it is a square or rhombus because diagonals are equal, it is a square. Diagonals are not equal, it is a rhombus. Clear? Then we can find out what AC and BD. Then the next two sides, two diagonals, that is AC. AC means AX1 by 1, CX2 by 2. That is minus 1, minus minus 2. The whole square plus 2 minus minus 2. Root of minus 1 plus 1, that is 0. 2 minus minus 2 plus 2, that is 2 square is, that is 4 square. Root of 4 square is 4.
First one is 16, total 16 is 4.
Then BD. Therefore, B is x1 by 1 and B is x2 by 2. That is root of minus 3 minus 1. Plus 0 minus 0, that is 0. That is root of minus 4 square. So that the root of 16 is equal to 4. Clear? That means diagonals are equal and all sides are equal. It is a square. Therefore, the conclusion, final answer is AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. They are equal, that is 2 root 2. AC is equal to BD is equal to 4. Therefore, ABCD, that is rectangle ABCD, is a square. That means diagonals are equal and all sides are equal, it is a square. Clear? Therefore, in the question 6, the first question we discuss, so we can work out the first question. The second, third questions for your homework. That means in this exercise, second question homework, fifth question, that is a figure. From that it is simple. So that is always a homework. And the sixth question, first question we discuss. Second and third question. Similarly, we can find out the all six lengths, that is sides and two diagonals. Using the values of this one, test one, we justify the answer as it is a rectangle or a square or any one. Okay? Then the seventh question, that is an important question. Seventh question, it is an important question. Seventh question is, find the point on x-axis which is equidistant from 2 minus 5 and minus 2 9. Find point on x-axis which is equidistant from given points 2 minus 5 and minus 2 9. What is by equidistant? That is equal in length. And what is the condition for a point on x-axis? Y coordinate is 0. That means A is 2 minus 5, B is minus 2, 9. There is another point P, x, y, y is 0. That is AP is equal to B. Then we can find out the value. For answer is what? A, 2 comma minus 5. B, minus 2 comma 9. P is what? X axis, we get the S coordinate on X, and Y axis 0. That is the answer. Any point on Y axis, therefore P is right as 0 comma 1 on Y axis. Given that what? Equidistant, that is equal length, AP is equal to BP. Then AB is root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. But square is what?
Not root.
Square is x2 minus x1. That is ab square is not root. X2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y2 whole square. Therefore, ab square is equal to bp square. What is distance? Root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. What is distance? But we know that these are equal, therefore we take the square, therefore not the square root. Therefore, in the case of AB, A or AX1 Y1 B X2 Y2. In the case of BP, B X1 Y1 and B X2 Y2. Therefore, not the root because square. That is X minus 2. The whole square plus 0 minus minus 5 the whole square, that is mp square. Bp square x minus minus 2 the whole square plus 0 minus 9 whole square, that is x minus 2 the whole square plus minus into minus is 5, 5 square is 25. Equal to minus into minus plus x plus 2 the whole square plus 9 square is 81. Okay. Then expand that x minus 2 the whole square and also x plus 2 the whole square. Therefore it is a minus 3 the whole square, that is a square. Minus 2 ab, minus 2 into 2 into x, that is minus 4x. Plus b square, that is 2 square into 4. Plus 25 is equal to, that is x plus 2 the whole square. S square plus 4x plus 4 plus 81. We know that in the left side s square, right side s square cancels these two. Left side 4, right side 4 cancels this. Therefore, shifting that the 81 to the left, that is 25 minus 81. 4x on the right. Minus 4x to right will be get plus 4x. That is 25 minus 81. That is minus 56 is equal to 8x. Therefore, x is equal to minus 56 by 8. And then numbers 8, 7, 7, 56. We can find out the point on x axis. Therefore, point is x is minus 7, y is 0. That is the answer. It is an important problem for your board exam. Okay. This is the answer for that question. Okay, that means we can find out the distance between two points using the distance formula, and to verify that a given triangle is isosceles means two lengths are equal, equilateral means four sides are equal, right angle triangle means the sum of squares of two sides is the square of third side. Then in the next episode we discuss about the next exercise. Okay.